Welcome to the second video in our series on cardiac arrest in children. Now let's look at the management of cardiac arrest in children. Providing immediate and proper attention is critical to the highest chance of survival of the child. In cardiac arrest management, the most crucial components are to activate emergency medical services and implement high-quality CPR continuously. It is important to note that there are different steps to take when it comes to treating a child with VT or VF versus treating those with asystole or PEA. After recognizing that a child exhibits signs of asystole or PEA, implement the following steps for treatment. Immediately activate EMS and start CPR with a cycle of 30 compressions to 2 rescue breaths. For high-quality CPR, open and support the airway, give oxygen and provide ventilation if necessary, and administer chest compressions at a rate of 100 to 120 compressions per minute. For children over a year old, attach a defibrillator. Then obtain vascular access to administer medication. Get lab tests to further evaluate the situation. Epinephrine should be administered via IV or IO access at a dose of 0.01 milligrams per kilogram and repeated every 3 to 5 minutes. Continue with 5 cycles of CPR. Check the child's rhythm to see if it is shockable or not, and continue to give high-quality CPR. For VF or VT, as soon as you identify a child with VF or VT rhythm, immediately activate EMS and start CPR. For high-quality CPR, start with a cycle of 30 compressions to 2 breaths, opening and supporting the airway, giving oxygen and ventilation, and providing chest compressions at a rate of 100 to 120 compressions per minute. For children over a year old, attach a defibrillator. Then obtain vascular access to administer medication. Get lab tests to further evaluate the situation. Give 1 shock at 2 joules per kilogram for children over the age of 1 and continue CPR, giving 5 cycles of CPR and then check the rhythm again. If the child has persistent VF or VT, give them another shock at 4 joules per kilogram, then resume CPR. Administer epinephrine to the child either via IO or IV access at a dose of 0.01 milligrams per kilogram and repeat every 3 to 5 minutes. Then perform 5 cycles of CPR and check the rhythm again. If persistent VF or VT is still present, give another shock at 4 joules per kilogram and continue CPR. Then administer amiodarone at a dose of 5 milligrams per kilogram via IV or IO access, or you may administer 1 milligram per kilogram of lidocaine via IV or IO. For torsades de pointe, or TDP, give the patient a dose of 25 to 50 milligrams per kilogram of magnesium via IV or IO. Continue CPR. This was the section on cardiac arrest in children of our Pediatric Advanced Life Support course. Please proceed to the next section of this course and review the corresponding videos.